Okay, so I was discussing about constant surface heat flux. Okay, so when you maintain constant surface heat flux, okay, what are all the formulas it will come? Okay, I was just discussing. So Q is equal to QS into AS, correct? No, MCP TE minus TI. Okay, this Q is equal to MCP TE minus TI is a general formula for constant surface heat flux as well as for constant surface temperature. And since constant heat flux means, okay, capital Q is nothing but small q represents heat flux into surface area, that is AS. So small q into area represents total heat transfer, right? And the mean temperature of that fluid you can calculate. Okay, you just simplify this equation 8.16 for what is TE. You are going to get TI plus QS into AS by MCP. And I told you from this figure, okay, it is TI represents the inlet temperature of the fluid which is entering into the tube, and TE is the outlet temperature. Okay, some books they will write as T naught also, TE or T naught. Okay, is nothing but outlet temperature or exit temperature of the fluid which is coming out of the tube. And temperature actually increases linearly. You can see this graph, temperature versus length. And constant heat flux has been applied on the surface of the tube, and the temperature of the fluid at the inlet TI is going to increase linearly to TE. And you can see here, since we are going to apply constant heat flux, we cannot maintain the surface temperature constant. It will vary. This also varies in a linear fashion. You can see here. So at any cross section, okay, what is the temperature difference? It is TS minus TM, that is the surface temperature and the mean temperature of the fluid. Correct? No. I told you, what do you mean by mean temperature? Okay, if you take at a particular cross section, at that cross section along the radial direction, the temperature varies. At the surface, the fluid temperature is the same as that of TS, and as you move towards the center of the tube, the temperature varies. So we are going to take average temperature or mean temperature. This you should know. This is very, very important. And also, if you want to calculate what is the surface temperature at the exit, okay, or at any point or at any cross section of this tube, how will you do it? So QS is equal to H into TS minus TM, where H represents heat transfer coefficient. Okay, this heat transfer coefficient we will take it as same at all the points. So QS is equal to H into TS minus TM. And what is TS? TS represents surface temperature at any cross section. Okay, is equal to TM plus QS by H. Now, if you want to find what is the surface temperature at the exit, that means at this point or at the outlet of the cylinder, what is the surface temperature? How will you do it? Okay, we are going to take TM as TE, correct? No, because if you see, this line is a mean temperature. At inlet, TM is equal to TI, and at the exit, TM is equal to TE. So at the exit means this TM will become TE, and TS, okay, represents surface temperature of the tube at the exit. That should be equal to TM plus TE plus QS by H, constant heat surface heat flux divided by the heat transfer coefficient. Okay, so this there's a small control volume has been taken. Okay, how the energy interaction takes place, let us just they have done here. Okay, see, if you are supplying heat to the fluid, heat has been transferred from the outside surface of the tube to the inside fluid which is flowing inside the pipe or tube. So what is the energy equation you can write? Okay, MCP TM is the energy of the fluid, okay, entering, and MCP TM plus DTM represents energy of the fluid which is leaving this control volume. And delta Q, okay, represents heat that has been transferred from the tube to the fluid in which is there inside the control volume. And you know that delta Q is equal to H into TS minus TM into DA, represents the heat transfer to this fluid. And this length of this control volume we have taken as dx. Okay, so this you should know. Okay, this why I am telling this is because there is one small derivation on this control volume when I am going to tell the constant surface temperature. Okay, now okay, go to this. See here, they have, this is actually the shape, the temperature shape of the temperature profile in a fully developed region. Okay, and this is subjected to constant heat flux. You can see a continuous arrow mark around the surface of the tube. See at the surface, okay, the fluid at the inside surface of this tube, the fluid which layer which is in comes in contact with the surface will have the surface temperature. Okay, and as you move towards the center, okay, the temperature of the fluid is going to decrease, is going to, because we have taken a cold fluid, no? So cold fluid, we have, when the cold fluid is flowing inside the tube and heat has been transferred from the surface to the fluid, so at the center the temperature will be minimum, whereas on the on at the inside surface of this tube the temperature of the fluid is maximum, correct? That is why we are going to take the mean temperature, understood? The okay, if you take this particular cross section, okay, the temperature of the fluid at the surface, it will reach the surface temperature of the tube, whereas the fluid temperature actually it is going to decrease, okay, and it is minimum at the center. Okay, and this you can see this is a constant temperature profile. Okay, next we'll move on to constant surface temperature. Okay, I told you either you can maintain constant heat flux or you can maintain constant surface temperature of the tube or cylinder. Now you know that from Newton's law of cooling, the rate of heat transfer to or from the fluid in a tube can be written as Q is equal to HAS into delta T average. Okay, here why we are taking delta T average, because see there are three temperatures which is going to come into picture. One is the inlet temperature of the fluid and the exit, and another one is the exit temperature of the fluid, and also we are going to maintain the surface temperature of the tube or the cylinder constant, which is TS. Okay, TS represents the surface temperature of the cylinder or a tube. So there are three temperatures here. Okay, now how will you do it? How will you calculate the difference of temperature? What we have done is HAS into TS minus T mean. Okay, how will you do it? The T mean is, you can see here this TS, okay, delta T is nothing but TS minus TI plus TE by 2, okay. So surface temperature, anyhow, it remain constant, okay, whereas the fluid temperature is continuously varying across the along the length of the tube. TI represents inlet temperature, TE represents exit temperature of the fluid coming out of the tube. So we are going to take the average temperature, that is TI plus TE by 2, or delta T here means TS minus, okay, average temperature of the fluid at the inlet and the exit. So TS minus TB, or bulk mean fluid temperature, okay, where TB is equal to TI plus TE by 2. Okay, this if you do this calculation, it is known as arithmetic mean temperature difference. Okay, we are going to take delta T using arithmetic mean temperature difference. One more thing is a logarithmic mean temperature difference also. See, Q is equal to HAS into LMTD, log mean temperature difference also we will use. Actually, that will give you the more accurate heat transfer instead of arithmetic mean temperature difference. Okay, we have to take logarithmic mean temperature difference. that I will explain you. Before that, there is a small derivation, that is how to calculate the exit temperature of the fluid which is coming out at the outlet or at the exit of the pipe. See, already I have shown you that control volume, no, just now. So for that we have written the energy balance. Okay, that means this one, for this okay, we have written the energy balance for this control volume. See, MCPTM is the energy of the fluid entering. MCPTM plus DTM represents the energy of the fluid which is leaving this control volume. Okay, what is the net energy transfer to this fluid element means? It is nothing but difference of this MCPTM plus MCPDTM minus this MCPTM. What you are going to get? MCP DTM, correct? No, MCPTM is energy of the fluid entering, whereas MCP into TM plus DTM is the DTM represents the in temperature that has been increased because of this heat transfer to this fluid. So what is the net energy transfer to this fluid in this control volume means? We have to take this difference MCPT, just expand this MCPTM plus MCPDTM, okay, and difference and minus of this MCPTM, what you are going to get? MCPDTM. Okay, how you got this? By because of this transfer of heat, which is H into TS minus TM into DA. Okay, here DA represents the surface area of this element. How will you calculate the surface area of this? Only just I want this element surface area. You should know perimeter into length. You know surface area is nothing but perimeter into length. What is the length of this element? Dx. Okay. So that is what they have written here. Okay. MCP DTM you are going to get on the left hand side. This is due to the heat transfer, which is nothing but H into okay surface temperature minus mean temperature of that control element fluid. Mean temperature of the fluid which is there inside the control element into DAS. Nothing but surface area. Understood? Okay. So now for DAS, what I can write? Perimeter into, I told you perimeter into length will give you surface area of that control element. So here the length of that element is dx, p into dx, and we can write dtm as minus of d into ts minus tm. Okay, so this dtm I can write it as minus of d into ts minus, okay, this difference in temperature, okay, dtm I can write it as ds minus tm. Since ts is constant, the above relation, okay, you can rearrange this term, okay, d into, that is for dtm I have written as ts minus tm divided by, okay, this ts tm minus tm which is there on the right hand side, take it to the left hand side, it comes to the denominator, that should be equal to, okay, minus is there, okay, because we have taken DTM as minus of D into TS minus TM minus, right? And the surface area is nothing but perimeter into DX. Okay, here H is there, H has been written, and MCP is there on the left hand side. When it comes to the right hand side, it comes to the denominator MCP. Okay, now it is just the integration. Okay, we have to do the integration of this. What you are going to get when you do this integration, okay, see on the left hand side this T mean is there, no, temperature will vary from Ti to T, correct? No, in a tube Ti represents the temperature of the fluid entering and T represents the temperature of the fluid at the exit. So temperature will vary from Ti to Te. And here, okay, HP by MCP, H, okay, we'll take it constant, okay, perimeter is a constant, pi d, M also constant, CP is also a constant, okay, and X will vary from 0 to L, 0 to L. See, very okay. If you integrate this, what is the integration of dx by x? You know, no? Integration of dx by x. Integration of dx by x is nothing but ln x. Similarly, here also integration, this ts minus tm, you can take it as x, ts minus tm denominator also x, okay, it will become ln of ts minus tm, correct, no? Sorry, ln of ts minus tm, and the temperature will vary from ti to t. See, ln ts, okay, I will write it as like this only, ln ts minus, for tm I can write it as t on one side minus ln of ts minus ti, ts minus ti, okay, correct, now for tm, for the same tm I can write it, replace with ti. Yeah, so log a minus log b is nothing but log a by b, that is what they have written here, ln of ts minus ti by ts minus ti, because it is log a minus log b. Okay, see, right hand side, if you take h into perimeter into dx is there, okay, if you integrate dx, it is x, correct, no? Integration of dx is x, and the length will vary from 0 to L, it is L minus 0, it will become L. So perimeter into length will become surface area, correct, no? Surface area is nothing but perimeter into length. What is the perimeter here, sir? Pi d. Pi d is the perimeter into length. Okay, that is the surface area. Perimeter is nothing but pi d. Okay. So once you got this, okay, you can express what is the how to calculate the exit temperature of the fluid coming out of the tube. Okay, see, what we can do is, okay, ts minus t by ts minus ti, you can, that should be, if you just express in the exponential form, correct, no? Logarithmic form, this is the in logarithmic form. If you want to express in the exponential form, okay, so how will you do it? Ts minus Te by Ts minus Ti is equal to exponential of minus HAS by MCP. Okay, this you should know, how to express in the exponential form whenever there's an equation, the logarithmic form. Okay, so you can write Ts minus Te by Ts minus Ti is equal to exponential of minus HAS by MCP. What is, we want what is Te, okay, just simplify. See here, once again, Ts minus Te divided by Ts minus Ti is equal to exponential of, inside the bracket, what it is going to come, minus HAS by MCP, that is what you are going to get. We want what is Te, okay, before that, okay, take Ts minus Ti to the right hand side, correct, no? So Ts minus Ti exponential of minus HAS by MCP, and what is Te, Te you can take it to the right hand side, and T, this will become Ts minus of Ts minus Ti, that is what they have written here, Ts, this equation is nothing but Ts minus of Ts minus Ti exponential of minus HAS by MCP. That should be equal to T, which is nothing but exit temperature of the fluid. Understood? Okay. So here you can see the figure here. Temperature versus length. Ti is the inlet temperature of the fluid. Te is the exit temperature of the fluid. And this is actually at any point, Tm is the temperature of the fluid. So that is nothing but mean temperature of the fluid. I told you temperature of the fluid at a particular cross section, it will vary from the surface to the core or to the center of the pipe. So we have to take mean temperature. Okay, see here delta Ti, they have written here delta Te. Actually, what is delta Ti means? It is nothing but Ts minus Ti. This you should know, because when I am telling LMTD, you should know what is delta Ti. It is nothing but Ts minus Ti. Delta Te means it is nothing but Ts minus Te. And if you see the surface temperature, okay, you see y-axis it is temperature, x-axis it is the length of the tube. And the surface temperature of the tube remains constant, no, because I told you condition is we are at constant surface temperature. So in a temperature versus length, that the line will become horizontal line, correct? No, that surface temperature, since it's a constant along the length of the tube, it should remain horizontal, whereas the temperature of the fluid is going to increase. Understood? Okay. So after that, okay, this HAS by MCP is there, no? This term HAS by MCP. This term is known as NTU, or number of transfer units. Okay. See, if the NTU is greater than 5, then the exit temperature of the fluid becomes almost equal to the surface temperature. Okay. See, our aim is to increase the temperature of this fluid from the inlet to the exit. Then how long should be the tube? It depends on the NTU. It depends on NTU, or is nothing but HAS by MCP. Suppose if that is equal to 5, means you can get almost the same temperature as that of this, the exit temperature of the fluid, you can get same as that of the surface temperature. If you see here, see inlet temperature of the fluid is 20 degrees Celsius. Okay. And the surface temperature, we are going to maintain the tube surface temperature at 100 degree. And if you want to have a 100 degree Celsius, or approximate 99 or 100 at the exit of the pipe, okay, that is a fluid temperature at the exit of the pipe, then your NTU should be 5. Then only you can see a 99. If it is less than 5, suppose if you NTU is equal to 1, means the exit temperature will be 70.6. okay, so there is always a chance you can increase the length of the tube, correct? No, because how will you increase this NTU? It is nothing but HAS by MCP. Heat transfer coefficient remain constant, mass flow rate Cp if you remains constant, only you can increase the surface area. Surface area is nothing but pi d, perimeter into length, that is nothing but pi d l. So increase the length of the tube. If you maintain diameter also constant, then increase the length. You can increase the length and you can make NTU equal to approximately 5, so that they can enhance the heat transfer. This also you should know. See, here we have got this equation, no? Equation number 8.29, this equation, okay, what is MCP that has been written? Okay, MCP is nothing but minus HA by this ln, correct? No, that has been written here, ln of TS minus TA by TS minus TA. Okay, it has been written in the okay, 1 second, I will increase this. You can see now, so MCP is nothing but HAS by ln of TS minus TE divided by TS minus TI, that is divided, they have written here, okay, TS minus TE by TS minus TI. Now, okay, you can substitute for MCP in equation 8.14. 8.14 is nothing but, what is that equation? That is nothing but Q is equal to MCP TE minus TI, correct? Equation number 8.14 is nothing but Q is equal to MCP TE minus TI. TE minus TI. TE minus TI. Okay, for MCP, I can substitute this minus HAS by ln of TS minus TI by, okay, what you are going to get? Okay, HAS. Okay, here you are going to get HAS into TE minus TI, that is, which is there inside the bracket, TE minus TI divided by what you are going to get, ln of TS minus TE divided by TS minus TI. Correct, no? See, HAS into TE minus TI. Okay, here one thing we forgotten, here minus sign is there. We'll put minus sign because for MCP it is minus is there, no? Here you can see equation number 8.31. MCP is equal to minus of this is there. So, you have to put minus. For MCP, I have substituted this equation. This is MCP. For MCP, I have substituted equation number 8.31. So, you have got this. If you take minus sign inside, this will become plus. This is actually, it will become TI minus TE, that's all. Correct, no? There is a TE minus TI is there. If you take minus sign inside, it will become TI minus TE. That has been written here. Okay. Now, just remember this TI minus TE, how I will write, just see here. So, TI minus TE, you have got in the numerator TI minus TE, you have got. How I can write this? You add one plus TS and minus TS, you can do it. Okay. See, TS and one more. I am going to add one TS and subtract one TS plus TI minus TE. This you got. Correct, no? Minus TE. See, plus TS, okay. Sorry, there is a minus TS. This should have been. Sorry. Okay. See, I have added one TS and I have subtracted one TS. Okay, plus TI minus TE. Okay. Now, how will you simplify this? Okay. Just simplify this. Okay, what you are going to get is, okay, delta T. What is delta T? It is nothing but TS minus TE. See, this is, there is a TS and this is minus TE is there. I am going to have this TS minus TE. Okay. That is this and this. TS minus T is there, I have written one, okay. And here I will write it as minus, okay, TS, right, no, minus into plus, minus TS you have got. Here we want plus, that is why we can write minus, because minus into minus it will become plus TI. See, TS minus T is nothing but delta TE, okay, and TS minus TI will represent delta TI, okay. I have told you, no, where is that, okay, see here, delta TI is nothing but TS minus TI, delta TE is nothing but TS minus TE, okay, that is a thing. So, delta TE is nothing but TS minus TE, minus of delta TI represents TS minus TI divided by ln of this delta TE. Correct, now TS minus TE is here and that has been written as delta TE. TS minus TI can write as delta TI. Here also they have written, okay, delta TI means what, delta TE. See, you have got Q is equal to HAS, okay, what is this? Delta T LM is there, that is nothing but log mean temperature difference. What is log mean temperature difference? Is nothing but the ratio of temperature difference, okay. Temperature difference, that is temperature difference means we have to take that exit temperature difference, inlet temperature difference divided by ln of this, again temperature ratio we have to take, okay. One is at the exit and another one is at the inlet, okay. That is with surface temperature difference we have to take. So, this is how you can do the or you can calculate the heat transfer whenever there is a constant surface temperature of the tube. So, we will do one problem. Water enters a 2.5 centimeter internal diameter thin copper tube of heat exchanger at 15 degrees Celsius at a rate of 0.3 kg per second and is heated by steam condensing outside at 120 degrees Celsius. If the average heat transfer coefficient is 800 watt per meter square Kelvin, determine the length of the tube required in order to heat the water to 115 degrees Celsius. Okay. See, there is a water, okay, fluid is your water, it is entering 2.5 centimeter internal diameter, copper tube is there, okay, and it is entering at 15 degrees Celsius, and mass flow rate they have given 0.3 kg per second, correct? No, mass flow rate they have given 0.3, and inlet temperature of the water is 15 degrees Celsius, is heated by steam condensing outside at 120 degrees Celsius, okay. See, around the surface there is a steam which is at 120 degrees Celsius. This is a problem on constant surface temperature, correct? No, constant surface temperature, because outside surface the temperature of the tube we are going to maintain 120 degrees Celsius, and they have asked to find, okay, they have also given the heat transfer coefficient 800 watt per meter square Kelvin. Determine the length of the tube required in order to heat the water to 115 degrees. Okay, exit temperature of the water also has been given 115 degrees Celsius. We want to find what is the length of this tube so that the water will enter at 15 degree and it comes out at 115 degrees Celsius. Around the surface of this tube, we are going to maintain the temperature of this surface at 120 degrees Celsius using steam. Using steam. So this is a problem on constant heat flux or constant surface temperature. It's a problem on constant surface temperature because they are not given heat flux. Okay, it is nothing but problem on constant surface temperature. See, first we'll calculate what is a heat transfer, because we know the inlet temperature and the exit temperature. So it is given by mcp te minus ti. See, mass flow rate they have given 0.3 Cp for water, you know, if they have not given, you can assume 4.187. Okay, 4.187 Te minus Ti. Okay, how much you have got? Actually, we have to calculate this value of Cp at mean temperature, because 15 degrees is inlet temperature, 115 is outlet temperature of the water. You have to take the average, it will come around 65 degrees Celsius. You have to go to the data handbook. From the data handbook, at 65 degrees Celsius, you have got this 4187 joules per kg Kelvin. Okay, this you know already, so that is why I am not showing any data handbook. Okay, in the data handbook, even properties of water is available. Okay, I will show you in the next class. Q is equal to, okay, mcp te minus ti, that is 115 minus 15, you are going to get 125.6 kilowatt, because difference of temperature of the exit and inlet temperature of the water you have got here. So you got Q value. Okay, since this is a problem on constant surface temperature, you can we are going to calculate the LMTD. Delta T is nothing but ts minus te. Okay, delta Ti is nothing but Ts minus Ti. See, Ts is the surface temperature of the tube, which is at 120 degrees Celsius. Exit temperature of the water is 115, and take the difference, you are going to get 5. Similarly, delta Ti, Ts minus Ti, surface temperature of the tube is 120, and Ti represents the inlet temperature of the water, which is 15 degrees Celsius, 105 degree you are going to get. Take LMTD. Okay, once you got LMTD, you are going to get 32.85 degrees Celsius. Okay, so delta T and delta Ti, just substitute ln of delta T by delta Ti, substitute 32.85, you are going to get. Next, the heat transfer surface area is given by Q is equal to H into As into log mean temperature difference. Our surface area is nothing but Q by H into log mean temperature difference. What is Q? Already we have calculated, no, using Q is equal to mcp Te minus Ti. That is this 125.6 kilowatts. Okay, so where is this? Here. Okay, 125.6. Okay, kilowatts only there. If you want, you can do it in watts only, because into 10 power 3. And here H. What is H? 0.8. ಎಷ್ಟು ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಎಚ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ 800 ವ್ಯಾಟ್ ಪರ್ ಮೀಟರ್ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಕೆಲ್ವಿನ್. ಇಫ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಟ್ ಇನ್ 800 ಓನ್ಲಿ, ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ಇನ್ ಕಿಲೋ. ಓಕೆ, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಅಪ್ ನ್ಯೂಮರೇಟರ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಿಲೋ, ಡಿನಾಮಿನೇಟರ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕಿಲೋ. ಆರ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ವ್ಯಾಟ್ಸ್ ಇಂಟು 10³, ಇಯರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಇಂಟು 10³, 10³, 10³ ಗೆಟ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸಲ್ಸ್. ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಡೂ ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಎಲ್ ಎಮ್ ಟಿ ಡಿ 32.85. ಓಕೆ, ಯು ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಗೆಟ್ 4.78 ಮೀಟರ್ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್ ಏರಿಯಾ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಯು ನೋ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್ ಏರಿಯಾ ಇಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಪೆರಿಮೀಟರ್ ಇಂಟು ಲೆಂತ್, ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಪೈ ಡಿ ಎಲ್. ಅವ್ರ ಎಲ್ ಈಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಈ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್ ಏರಿಯಾ ಬೈ ಪೈ ಡಿ. ಯು ಹವ್ ಗಾಟ್ 61 ಮೀಟರ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ಎಲ್ ಎಮ್ ಟಿ ಡಿ. ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಐ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಯು ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಡೂ ಇಟ್ ಬೈ ಅರ್ಥಮೆಟಿಕ್ ಮೀನ್ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಇನ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಗೆಟ್ 36 ಮೀಟರ್, ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಗ್ರಾಸ್ ಲೀನಿಯರ್, ದಿಸ್ ಶೋ ದ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ಎಲ್ ಎಮ್ ಟಿ ಡಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು.